Murders, they called them. It was the state, they said. Family members of Mexico's disappeared and imprisoned gathered in front of the White House on Tuesday as Mexican President Enrique Peña Nieto met with President Obama. As the United States sends military aid to its neighbor to the south, protesters say it's difficult to differentiate between the drug war and state violence.
Just like the students, my brother was taken by people that were dressed like police.
Jose Luis Avila Baez's wife is both a U.S. citizen and a political prisoner in Mexico.
The accusations against her are absurd and false. Even so, she's still in a maximum security prison and the United States hasn't done anything.
Since 43 students went missing last September in Iguala, Mexico, and only one victim's remains have been found, what Nancy and Jose Luis fear the most is indefinite impunity.
If they haven't done anything for the students that have been all over the world on the news and everything, they're not going to do anything for my family. They're not going to do anything to find my brother.
With 100,000 dead and 27,000 missing in Mexico in the past decade, they aren't alone. The United States has given the Mexican government over $2 billion since 2007 to combat drug trafficking, support that's conditioned by Mexico fulfilling certain human rights requirements. But protesters here say that state security forces implicated in the deaths and disappearances of thousands of Mexican citizens goes unprosecuted and without investigation. In Washington, I'm Alexandra Hall for Telesur.